Dear Atiya, I'm writing after I saw your video on quitting my PhD. I'm an enthusiastic person to learn if I'm getting proper environment. I came for my PhD in last September. I successfully completed the first semester, but with lots of stress on my head. It was so difficult to me because I never had time to run through all notes before the exams. We were filled with time-taking assignments, but anyhow, I did that. Then I started my thesis work, but I'm not happy with my supervisor. Knowing this at very beginning, I tried to change him, but it didn't happen because the person whom I wanted to change said he's super busy and continue working with the former. He is a very tough and strict person. Anyway, my whole first semester ended in utter failure. I have got 2 more months to give my proposal. Now I'm trying to find another supervisor. Since I have received fully funded scholarship, if I quit, I will have to pay back money to the institution. I'm afraid of this situation. Can you please help me to make my mind? Because I can't bear such a large cost. Regards, Soapcase. So, if you are wondering what was that I just read at the beginning, it was one of my subscribers' letters. So here on this channel, I run a series and it's aimed at trying to give different perspectives to the reader's queries. So when I say reader's queries, I mean subscriber's queries or viewer's queries. So this is one such email that I received, and I thought this is something that most research scholars would relate to. So I will give my perspective, of course, but that may not be the only solution, or that may not be the only perspective or view. If you are a research scholar at any stage of your PhD, then what I want you to do is comment below what you feel should be the solution of this. You can comment from an anonymous account, because the letter also that I've received is, I've changed the name. So you will be referring to her or him as Soapcase, and you can give your inputs in the comment. Okay, so that's what I wanted to say before I start with my sermon. So let's begin with some of the things that I've observed in this letter and what can be done about it, what are the different perspectives to it. Coming to this, I can totally relate to this particular letter, and I'm sure many of the research scholars also will, because there are different stress levels, and initially you are new to the system, so your stress levels are really high. This is my 5th year and I feel stress levels are quite manageable now that most of the work is complete. But if it was my 2nd year or 3rd year, or even 1st year for that matter, in 1st year we had experiments plus coursework, so the stress levels were really like to the roof. So stress levels increase gradually and then they will decrease. So work stress is there only, but most stress that comes is usually from the toxicity, usually from the supervisor. And if colleagues are not well balanced in their head, then half of your stress might come from there also. So here are some of the things that I would like to draw your attention. This video will not give you a solution, but it will provoke you to think in a direction that you may have not thought of earlier previously. So that's my job. I am no counselor and I have no degree in psychology, but these are some of the perspectives that I would like to share since I have been in this field for a couple of years. I get a lot of questions on and in my mail also on what are the criteria of choosing supervisor, tell me which supervisor is best. So whenever I read the responses, the first thing is, your supervisor needs to be approachable rather than tough and strict, because in PhD you are just answerable to your supervisor and you are only answerable to your supervisor. So if the supervisor is not proper with respect to communication, communication plays a really crucial role. So if that is not in place, then you may have the best institute, you may have the best topic, and you may have the best facilities. It will not work out eventually. So approachability over strict and tough is one of the criteria. Also, what I want to suggest prospective research scholars is when you are going to choose supervisor, just choosing accomplished supervisors who have many awards and accolades. Most of the times what happens is these are the same supervisors who don't have time for their research scholars. So this is also one of the things that I would like to draw your attention to. This was for prospective research scholars if they are watching this video. Now, as far as this particular case is concerned, having the right supervisor, if you are not able to approach or if you are not able to get your queries solved, then this is not something that you might want to go for. If you have to change supervisor, then this is the right time before the proposal. So what you can do is you can delay the proposal. You can say that right now you are not ready, you will give your proposal in some time. And this will give you a time to reflect also on what is going on. It will also give you time whether you want to really go ahead with this supervisor, and it will give you a time to find a new supervisor because the documentation and all does take time. So you can just request to your current supervisor that you need some time, and you don't have to mention the reason that you want to change the supervisor, but you can just mention some work-related reasons, that few experiments you want to finish before you give your proposal. And you can just give an excuse and delay the proposal, because ultimately proposal cannot be given without your signature and without documentation from your side is submitted. I don't know which fellowship is this, because there is no clear mention of the fellowship, and I don't know which institute you are emailing me from. As far as I know, you never have to return PhD scholarship money. And if you have signed any document or anything, you can share the screenshot with me, because as of now, I don't know of any fellowship or any institute who is asking you to sign papers so that if you don't finish your PhD, you have to return the money. So you don't have to return the money as far as I know. So you can be rest assured about that. You also spoke about quitting, okay? Quitting PhD is an option. And if you have to quit, then this is the best time for the proposal. You are not too much into the process and you have so many years left. And if you wish to quit, then this is the right time. What I would suggest is, instead of quitting, changing supervisor would help in your case, or rather than the institute or quitting. Okay, because I feel if you really had to quit, then you would have quit long back. That means you are really passionate about research and you really want to pursue research. It is just that circumstances are not in your favor. This is my conclusion from what I have read. So my suggestion is, go for a change in supervisor rather than institute or quitting. See how it works out in 6 months. You still have a lot of time. If it doesn't work out, and if you feel that research is something not for you, because research is not for everyone. Like if somebody asks me to play cricket, I know it is not for me because I'm not built that way and it's not something that I would want to do. So in a similar manner, research is not for everybody. There are a lot of things that people think what research is, but it is actually not. So my suggestion is to see for 6 months how it goes, and if it doesn't work, then quit. But for now, change in supervisor would help more than changing institute or quitting the research, as per what I've thought. If you are some other research scholar apart from Soapcase, and then please give your comment and feedback on this particular question. What should be the way out for this person? Because if you know, PhD is really a stuck situation where you have to think of so many parameters before you actually make the decision. Okay, I want you to comment down below. With that, it's a wrap. If you enjoy this series and if you want me to make more videos around this, then also do let me know, because mostly my scholarship videos get more views as compared to these videos. So do let me know if you are enjoying this and if you want more changes. With that, it's a wrap. Till the next time.